one of the dies in this set is the bamboo trellis. Now, we had it in an embossing folder, but talking with Spellbinders, decided to kind of bring it to life and make it into a structure that we could, you know, color and have for our flowers, especially for the next one coming up, which is the delphinium that I'll show you shortly. But I just wanted to go over, you'll see it comes in this piece here, and what you do is cut, well, I've cut four, but because I'm going to glue them together, but you can stack them. So, you know, to keep the price of the die down, we kind of think of these things that you're able to make it as tall as you like. If you want a short one for just, you know, some short climbing vines, that's fine too. So the other thing is we've added, you know, all the little nuances of the trellis, like those little growth nodes in the bamboo. I've got them here, and then the ties. So when I was in Tokyo several years ago, I noticed they had these bamboo trellises everywhere. Bamboo is a sustainable product, and so, you know, it's easy to replenish. It's not like cutting down our forests. So they really think about the bamboo. Now, I'll color my trellis, but then to cut these little pieces, I've also colored some cardstock. Here, I've got one there. this color was Sahara, kind of a bamboo color. And you only really have to, I colored both sides, but then realized I only have to color the one. And then this color was Acorn in VersaFine Clair to do the ties. But you could cut it in, you know, in colored cardstock. You don't have to go to the trouble of coloring like I do. But, you know, as you can see, I can get quite a few pieces out of these little 4.25 by 5.5 pieces of cardstock. And I'll keep this aside and probably do more and just put them in little jars so I have them ready. Like I said, I like to cut two. It doesn't tell you to cut two. I mean, you would actually cut two to put the two together. But I ended up cutting four because I want the structure to have a little bit of thickness to it. So I cut two to stack them. And I've always got leftover, you know, 100-pound cardstock from cards that I make. And so this is a perfect way to use that up. Now I'm just going to take my little glue gun here with and add some glue on one side and down these little strips. Actually put them together before I color them, so I think I got it all. And then I'm just going to stack it on top of each other. And by using glue, you have some wiggle room to line it up. And so if I bring in one here, you can see the difference. Oops, let's push that together. You can see how that gives it a little bit more thickness. It's not that it needs to be sturdy. It's just I like the dimension of it. So if you choose, you'll need to cut four to make, you know, a nice tall trellis. We'll move that out of the way. And if you don't, you don't. So, like I said, I just take, and I'm going to use the Sahara here, and a blending brush, and just go over it. Now I'm trying to keep it in a bamboo color. Usually I like to put a piece of cardstock here so you can take off some of it so I don't get that darkness. And I would do this to both pieces after I put them together. And you can see it has the markings on it for the nodes and the twine. Show you quickly how I do this. Grab my little gun here again, and I'm gonna just put little dabs These are the nodes that, and you can see where they go on the trellis. Okay, we'll do a few there. And then I just simply add the pieces on top of each other. I know, a little tedious, but you know what? It's all in the detail of how you create this. And it really makes a difference, you know, to have that dimension and bring it, like I said, to life here. So we'll do a couple more on here. See, there was one there, here. Oops. Get glue on your fingers and they'll stick to your fingers. So, oh, I've got one more here. I've got some on the top, but you get the idea. You're just simply gluing these wherever you see the embossed piece. And then for the ties, I've done that in that acorn color. But again, you could cut it out of cardstock. The craft cardstock would be good. They do tie their bamboo with twine, gardening twine. So I've tried to, you know, kind of imitate that. But and then you'll see the way these X's form. They fit perfectly, oops, over those areas. And one more here, oops. And the way, you know, you can see which way is the bottom because you'll see that little curved piece and it looks like it curves around the bamboo pole. But we fill this in and I'm going to bring in my project that I'm going to work on with the delphinium. So I have a nice tall one here and you see I've made this into a tower card. So I'm going to add the delphinium right on to the acetate. So these are those little side pieces from the Arbor embossing folder that I've decorated. That wasn't my idea. Melanie Dye of our design team came up with this idea to do that. And it just kind of encloses, almost makes it look like it has an arbor as you're looking into the garden. So stay tuned. We'll do the delphinium next. Into the garden, we see the delphiniums. Now, these are, you know, tall, beautiful plants. They could be compact too, but they grow. Some grow as tall as 6 feet. They require full sun, but the colors are gorgeous, from purples, both light and dark, blues, pinks, white. You'll have an array of color to add to your garden. And they're not hard to do, a little tedious, but not hard. And let me show you. We'll get started here. So the dies, you'll see the stem, I've actually added two pieces to the stem. So you'll cut and you'll put them together because like I said, these are tall plants. So if you were doing a slimline card or an 8x8 card, these would be perfect with that. They're not going to go on your, you know, A2 cards, maybe not even A6 because they're pretty tall. And then you have the leaves and they have quite a bit of foliage leaves around their base. So I say cut them two times. That would give you four per plant. And if you put more than, you know, one or two plants on, you could cut it even more. And then you have the petals. Now the petals are, you'll see them here. And I tell you to cut it six times. So there's, let's see, one, two, three, four, five. So cut it six times, you'll get, you know, 30 blossoms. That'll give you a really full one and actually give you some buds at the top. And then you've got a plate with the stamens on it and a little calyx, because these are going to have to be built on your project, and I'll show you that in a second. So you're going to need something to hold up, because when I was, you know, when you're doing a stem, putting those little branches out would, you know, they'd be too flimsy. So I thought of another idea. So we'll get started in just a second. So the first thing I'm going to do, I cut the calyx and the stamen are on the same plate. I'm going to go ahead and color, whoops, wrong green. Picked up the wrong one. This is YG8.5. I'm going to do the calyx in. This is a little base that's going to hold up your flowers. Let me flip it over here. I'd like to say you could cut this out in green cardstock, but if you remember what the plate looked like, it does have both the calyx and the stamens. So, you know, unfortunately, you'll have to do them in white and then color them. And then here's the stem. I'm going to do those in a second. I'm going to put two stems together, and I'll tell you why I do that. Not only for some, you know, dimension, but these top little areas are going to hold your buds. So I'm going to bend, well, I'm going to color them first. Let's color them, and then I'll show you how I bend them. So we're going to add some green here. And then this is that extension to the stem that you'll need. Now on this one, turn it over and color the underside, because you're going to put two together. No sense coloring a side you're not even going to see. So I'm going to color this the wrong side. It doesn't tell you to cut two stems, but I will tell you it's easier. And not only does it give you dimension, but you'll see when we add those tight little buds, because this is a flower that blooms from the bottom up. So this is the back side. I have my little gun here, and I'm only going to add it down the stem side. I'm not putting it on those projections, if you notice. But before I put this one on, I want to curve these inward. I'm just pinching them around my tweezer here. And then I'm going to put them together. Good reason to use glue is so you can have a little bit of wiggle room there. And that's the top of your stem. And then I'm going to put the bottom part here. That's your extension. So there's your two pieces. And you know, I am going to go back and on this one here, because you might see some of it. I'm going to just go ahead and color those on both sides, those little projections. You don't want to glue them together, you just want them. And since I took that apart, let me put a little bit more glue there, right down the center, and just set them apart there. So what you should get, if I squeeze this together, you can see it gives you a little opening. And I'm going to just hold that like that, because you want to be able to slip the buds in there. Now for your flowers, like I said, there's so many colors. I'm gonna do this beautiful blue. I've got some made here. And I'm just going to, this is, I picked up the green. Pick up the right ones. This is BV 2.6. It's that beautiful kind of purplish blue. And I'm leaving the center white on this one. Flip it over. And the same with this. So it's a five petal flower, although there are some delphiniums that are doubles. And certainly if you want to cut more and put more together, have at it. It's up to you. And I'm just showing you singles today. I'm going to put these on my molding mat here. If I can pick it up there. Let me wipe up my surface. And then for your stamens, grab your scissors. I'm going to cut them apart. You can see because these are littler flowers, you're going to have a tendency to really get ink all over you, I think. And then my tweezers here, let me grab them. Grab the little tail. And then I'm just gonna take some glue and paint my, I left the calyx white. And then roll it up. Now these are tiny, so just take a finger there and kind of flip them a little bit. I'm gonna bring in some black pollen. Dip a little bit of glue and then dip it in the pollen. We're gonna set these aside. So let me show you my project. You saw it earlier with the trellis. I've put on the, it's acrylic, and I did build myself a little acrylic, I don't know if you can see it, another little acrylic box there, just because the stem gets heavy. I wasn't sure if it would bend in the middle, so since it's going to be covered up anyway, I did a little tower of acrylic there to hold up my stem and keep it nice. So what I've done is you're going to take, let me see if I can make some room here so you can see. So you're going to take your small ball stylus and cup your calyx. And then I'm just going to take some glue and we'll bring it over here. This is the Kids' Choice glue, and just a little bit on the bottom. And you can start building it, putting them, spacing them on your, I put some going up the stems. Let's see, I've got more here. You can put these in place first, or you can build as you go. I know there's gonna be some spacing there. And they really, I guess the look of them, I don't know if you can see, I don't know if this is a really good picture, but they almost look like a triangle. They're wider at the base and then go up. So I'll probably add a few more here and then taper up that way. You can set these in place anywhere. Like I said, I've got some already done. So I can add in on the side here. I've actually been making them and putting them in my tray here, so they set up nicely. So that's what I have here. But on these, it's real easy to do. You just take your loop tool and you're going to shape each petal. I'm just softly pulling it towards me there. And then with your tweezers, you want to kind of pinch them in the center there and bend down. And then with your small ball stylus, you're going to cup it. And this is another one where the, let me bring in my gluing one here. So I'm going to put some glue on my three petal one and set it with the on the two petal with it facing upward like that. So now I've got it pretty much filled. You certainly, this will, I've cut 24, so you can fill in more if you like. But let's talk about these little buds up here. I've got one made. So what you're going to need is a few more of the petals. And this is part of the 24. So one you're going to put together just like you did with your other ones. The only difference is we're going to do with the right sides on the out. And what I did, these are usually green or pale green. So I took that pale green and colored those completely. But the one that will have the five petal, I'm picking up a little bit of the blue and pulling it out just in the center there. I could have also done this in a light blue, but I wanted to maintain that green color as if the bud is still really tight. So with your molding mat, and let me wipe up my mat here. Bring in your loop tool again. And that one you colored with a little bit of blue, you're going to put it with the right side down on your mat this time. When we made the flowers, it was right side up. But this is going to close up, so you want to have it have the night, you know, the good side on the outside. You're still going to pinch them. And you're still going to cup it. Bring in my glue mat here. Set this down. And go ahead and put some glue on the underside there so you can put the two together. Taking my hands and pinching that so it closes up. Now, if you want to add a stamen in this, you can. Let me grab my scissors. You don't see it, but you know, if you had it off to the side, you might want to add one. And then you can just slip it right down in the center. So you have two of those. That's for the first line here. And then you've got four more. So for the next ones up, you're just going to add the three petal ones. These two petals are going to be for the top. So it's like you're going to split it apart because you don't want it as full. And then go ahead and shape these two. So I've got all the buds made. I'm going to bring my project in here for a second. So the ones that were five petals, but you closed it up, I'm going to dip it in the glue and I'm going to slide it, I think, there we go, right into that section there. And a second one on the other side. That's why I did the two. Let me turn this way so I can grab it. And then you've got the ones that are three petals. Hold it together, you can dip it in the glue, and then they're gonna go into this section. And put a little bit of glue on the inside, help hold that together. I even like to pinch at it so it stays somewhat closed. And then finally the two petal. Again, if you put a little bit of glue on the inside and then pinch at it, it'll stay together better. And then they go at the top here. There we go. And so you have your delphinium with your trellis behind it to give the illusion it's sitting in front of it. We need to add some leaves next. I've colored the leaves in that green color, that YG 8.5. And then I'm going to take my leaf tool. And because, again, these are finer leaves, I'm not going to be able to bend them. So I actually put them on my speedball mat here, and with the right side facing you, I'm giving you, you know, doing the vein or the stem line down each one of these. I can't add my pan pastel, but I can take a fine line pen and just kind of lightly go up that stem line with the green to accentuate the stem line. There's my molding mat here, and then use your medium ball stylus. Well, first I'm going to bend on these and bend them in a little bit just to, so they're not flat. We don't do two-dimensional flowers, we do three-dimensional flowers. And then with that medium ball stylus, you can just cup it in the center. Take and add some glue behind here, a little bit of glue. And like I said, it's got really thick foliage. So go ahead and, you know, add as more if you want, instead of just the four. I'm gonna put another one on here just to fill up that bottom, make sure it locks down. There we go. Now all we have to do is bring in our little ladybug, and I'm gonna put some glue on her, I guess, here. Might be helpful if I use the wetter glue there. And I'm gonna set her right in the center here. So we've gone through the arbor release, and I hope you have enjoyed this and you create some beautiful bouquets going through your arbor. Mm-hmm.